Today, we are looking at the new STECS Throttle from VKB. STECS stands for Single Twin Engine Control System, and this is VKB's new modular throttle design. In full disclaimer, VKB did send me this throttle for free in exchange for a review. Before we get into the review, let's quickly go over the STECS models for a quick comparison. First, the Mini. The Mini is a very basic unit that comes with just the throttles and pre-configured button setup with no extra modules. Next is the Mini Plus. The Mini Plus builds on the Mini, but comes with an additional module called the ATEM module, or Auxiliary Throttle Extension module, which is a small button box that sits at the back of the throttle. Next, we have the Standard. The Standard comes with the Throttle and Stem module. The Stem, or Standard Throttle Extension module, is a larger button box over the ATEM module and sits at the back of the throttle. It also comes with a set of customizable module buttons, detent frames and shapes, and throttle grip pads. The last module is the Max. The Max comes with both STEM and ATEM modules, along with all the other accessories from the Standard. Today, we are looking at the STECS Standard. Starting at the back side of the right throttle, there is a single trigger. Moving to the right, we have one analog mini stick with center push, three pre-configured modules, which are a two-way plus depress, a four-way plus depress, and a single button. At the bottom, there is one single wheel axis. Moving to the front of the right grip, there is one single button, two pre-installed modules, which are a four-way plus depress, and a single button. And in the front of those, we have a single trigger. Moving to the left throttle, in the front, we have another trigger. The left side contains a rotary encoder, and a way to unlock the grips so that you can perform your best Maverick split throttles moment. Then moving from the front, we have two buttons, another rotary encoder, and one more trigger. Moving to the base of the throttle, on the right, we have three more controls, two buttons and a five position rotary switch. Now, these are multi-purpose buttons. They do register on the controller as buttons and a rotary switch, but you also use them to reinitialize the device and to change the detent profile you are using. So be careful with these bindings as you may inadvertently activate something. At the back of the base, we have the stem module. This contains a self-centering two-way switch, a three-way switch, two rotary encoders with depress, two K switches with center button, and eight additional buttons. Now let's take a look at the modular customizations available on the STECS Standard. The Standard comes with a tray containing three buttons and three four-way plus depress hats. Since the pre-installed configuration has only two single button modules, I opted to pull those out and swap them for the four-way hats. This is really simple. Just two screws on each module. A simple Mullex connector to remove the module from the wire. It's important to note here that there is a small tab that secures the cable to the module, so be careful when removing the module and don't tug on it. Simply squeeze the connector and pull the module away from the wire rather than the wire away from the module. Next, clip the wire into the new module and reseat it back into the throttle using the two screws. After swapping out the modular buttons, you need to recalibrate the device in order for it to recognize the newly swapped out modules. You can see this by checking if the lock light is blinking when you plug it in. To recalibrate the device, simply hold down the ENT and front trigger on the right throttle while you plug in the USB. Once the three lights go off, you can let go. Then turn the white rotary knob at the right side of the throttle to position 3. Press and hold the gray and red buttons on each side of the knob until the on light turns red. Once you release, the throttle will restart and you're good to go. The next customizable component is the throttle grip pads. The standard comes with one color installed and two other colors as accessories. These swap out with 4 simple screws, 2 at the front and 2 at the back. The last customizable part is the detents. In total, there are 5 different shapes for detents. There is the L, both tall and short. The tall one can be used for an idle off stop or something where you don't want to revert the detent once passing it. The short one can be used for something like an afterburner, something you need to push over to engage. The next one is the V detent, both short and tall. These basically just give you a different feeling, but kind of the same purpose as the L. They're a little bit easier to get through versus the L variant, but ultimately is just a different feeling. And the last one is the W shape. And this one you can put in a position where you want to be able to engage that position exactly, and you don't want the throttle to move back or forward out of it. I tried out multiple configurations for different jets, different detent shapes for each of the detent positions. Suffice it to say, this was where I spent a lot of my time. I really like the idea of being able to swap out detents and being able to customize each one to your liking. What I've learned, however, is that you need to keep them really simple. For instance, I created a detent that had an idle off stop along with a 3-stage burner for the biggin. I quickly realized and learned that the software only supports 3 detents in total. So I removed the idle off detent and kept the 3-stage burner. But these were just a little bit too far apart, and I couldn't put them any closer together due to the backing plate that they're screwed into. So eventually, I realized that a single idle off detent and one afterburner was probably the best setup for most things. To create these detents, you simply grab a plate, grab the shapes you wish to install, and put them where you see fit. Then, just remove the screw that holds in the current frame, carefully pull the frame out, slide in the new frame. You want to be sure that the frame is all the way in by pushing the throttle forward and checking that the front of the plate is flush. Pull the throttle back and reseat the screw to hold it in position. Next, press and hold the gray button to the right of the throttle and turn the rotary knob until the light matches the same color as the frame you've installed. Now we need to configure the detents. First, you're going to pull the throttle all the way back past the first detent. We're going to click into the configuration wizard for the first detent. We're going to select the type, in this case, a tall L or idle detent. We want the initial position to be right up against the beginning of the detent. Once it's set, click next, then push the throttle over the detent and pull it back so it touches the backside of the detent. And now our first detent's done. So on to the second detent, or our afterburner detent. First, we choose the afterburner detent. In this case, it is another L, but the small one. Then we're going to push the throttle all the way up to the beginning of the detent and click next, then push it over and pull it back to the end of the detent and click finish. And now we have our setup. Now there's one more thing we have to do. Because we're setting up an idle off detent, we want to set the curve of the detent to begin at zero as soon as the throttle skips over the detent. So with our curve set to zero, you can see that as I advance the throttle, the black carrots are moving, which is the raw value, but the red, which is what is actually sent from the throttle to the computer, is still at zero. And when I move it past the detent, that's when the red line starts moving. Now, under the hood, there is some compression used so that the red will eventually catch up to the raw value, again, the black carrot, and at some point they should meet and be 1-to-1. For us, this happens at the afterburner detent. And as we push through the afterburner detent, you can see that the value does not change until, again, we are past that detent. The afterburner will not kick in until you've pushed through the detent completely. Okay, next we want to go to the test page, and here we're going to pick a button we want to use when we want to kick the throttle out of the off and into the idle detent. In this case, I'm going to pick the right trigger. Next, we go back to the profile screen and the detents tab. We're going to switch the event type to the greater than symbol. This means that when the value has moved past the detent, we want to fire an event. We're going to set the left button to 16, which is the right trigger from the back of the throttle. And we're going to check the pulse button. And this is essentially going to pulse or click the right trigger when the throttle advances past the detent. Now, after every change, you want to go ahead and hit this set button. This is going to push your changes to the device. If we move over to the test page again, we can see that as we advance the throttle, a small pulse happens on button 16. Okay, so let's look at this in DCS. When we advance the throttle, the in-game throttle doesn't move out of the idle off detent, so we need to set that up. So we go to the binding screen, we find the throttle idle binding. We set it to button 16, which is the right trigger. And now when we advance the throttle moves out of the off to the idle detent. But when we advance the throttle a little bit more, we notice we are a little shy on where the afterburner detent should be. Pushing it up and over, you can see that it then hits it, so we need to fix that. So first, we remove the detent slide from the throttle, move the afterburner detent about 10 degrees forward, then put the slide back in. Next, we come to the VKB configurator tool and reset up the detent just as we did before, and don't forget to save it by hitting the set button. Now, when we move back into the game, you can see that our detent is set up properly, and if we push over the detent, we can engage the afterburner. Now, it might take a few attempts trying to get them lined up to the correct position with DCS or other flight sim software, but you can do this all without having to restart the game, which really helps a lot. Okay, so now that you've seen everything, let's talk about my thoughts on this throttle. I think the price is amazing. Starting at around $199 Freedom Dollars for the Mini, $219 for the Mini Plus, $279 for the Standard, and $319 for the Max, the STECS Throttle is a competitive answer for the niche high-end throttle market. The build quality is excellent. It's made with ABS plastic, and in areas that need more rigidity and strength, glass fiber reinforced plastic is used. It's made with Japan OEM Alps buttons, MARS sensors for the throttle axis. The modular buttons and the primary detent system is a great touch. Now, most of you will probably grab the buttons you want, install them, and leave them alone. But the fact that you can put them where you want is certainly a nice touch. Being able to make multiple different types of detents and basically hot swapping them out as needed is awesome. I did have a quick conversation with VKB about the detents. I explained the idea of wanting smaller detents for things like multi-stage burners, and they explained to me that they are definitely open to requests and could come up with an extra detent package at a later date. One of the things I expressed to VKB is that it would be nice to feel a position on the throttle, but not require a lot of force to enter or exit that position. As an example, it would be nice to be able to feel where 80% power is for a section takeoff, but not to the extreme of having to push through a detent, just a little click. Being able to increase the power and feel a small bump when you get to 80% would just be a nice addition. A couple of things that I would like to see improved would be the two-way air brake module. I wish that this locked into place like other throttles, or at the very least, another module with the same shape that was a two-way switch instead. The thumb mini stick is a bit strange as well. It took me a long time to figure out what exactly my gripe with it is. See, I've been using the Warthog throttle for years, and that throttle has a mini stick situated to be used by your middle finger in the front of the throttle. Now, initially, I thought my issue with the STECS mini stick was that my thumb just didn't have the muscle memory that my finger would from the Warthog. And after a day or two, I really couldn't get used to it. But now, after using it for quite a while, it has got better, and I kind of realized what the problem is. See, when you move the throttle forward and back, your thumb changes position ever so slightly, and you end up getting cross input on the two different axes. Now, I totally believe that over time, this will probably just completely go away. It's just going to take some repetition and to build up that muscle memory. But I don't think I've ever had this problem with the mini stick that's situated on your finger in the front of the throttle. So just keep that in mind if you purchase this. And the last thing that I would like to see changed, I've already stated before. Being able to have smaller detents or more of them might be a nice addition. And it is really great to hear that VKB is open to feedback in this area. I want to thank you guys for watching. Remember to smash that like button and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys next time.